All right. Let's start the session. Let's close the eyes, back straight, hands in Dhyan Mudra. Let's chant three long Omkars, followed by the opening prayers. Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvina Vaditamastu Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Keep the eyes closed, join the hands at back of the body, bow down to the Mother Supreme Earth. Raise both hands up over the body. Inhale, come back up. Rub the palms against each other. Generate urja, make them warm. Press warm hands over the eyes and face. Open and close eyes few times in dark under the palms. Slowly slide the hand down over the face, gently open the eyes. And let's start with some light exercise, some warm up. Keep the arms straight, extend hands forward, roll the palms up and down.
Bluetooth connected.
We're just fixing the music. Okay. Alternate few times. Make tight fist and release. Spread the fingers apart. Can still keep the palms 90 degrees up. Roll the palms into one direction. We are not moving like this. We are keeping our arms completely still from shoulders to the wrist. Just use the wrist joint to circle the palms. Reverse direction, few circles. And swing the arms up and down. Folded elbows. Deep inhale up. Deep exhale down. Sideways few times. Keep the full awareness on all these small activities and notice that we are utilizing all the joints, body parts, muscles. Now hold all the fingers together over the shoulders and circle the elbows at the biggest possible. Inhale upward, exhale downward. And reverse. And relax. Extend the hands sideways. Turn the palms 90 degrees up. Circle the palms around the shoulders. keeping the elbow straight, both arms completely extended, palms circling in full circle, all the directions equally from the shoulders. Reverse the direction. And relax. Immediately you can feel some great sensations coming out from the shoulders and upper arms. Next, as we inhale, raise both hands up, stretch the upper body upward. Exhale, twist upper body to the one side, look back, align chin with the shoulder, keep pushing the knee forward, feel the full stretches. Inhale, back to center. Exhale to the second side. Keep the back straight, trunk vertical for the better stretches. Inhale, back to center. And let's do one more time, both the sides. Come back and complete onto the second side. Come back to center. Next, let's interlock the fingers, place the palms over the forehead. Deep breath in, hold the breath as we push head and palms against each other. Release the breath, release the palms and from back of the head. First, try to keep the head, neck and trunk in vertical line. And one more time, from front of the head, then back of the head. And from side of the head, let's do twice on both the sides alternatively. Do with breath coordination. This will release the physical tension around neck and shoulder region. We should feel it. Next, let's look at straight at the level of the eyes. Deep inhale. As we exhale, turn the head towards the right side. Align chin with the right shoulder. Look back at farthest. 4, 5. Inhale, back to center. Exhale to the second side. Feel the stretches at the neck muscle, the neck joint. Inhale, back to center. One more time, we should not be moving the shoulder blades, just head and neck. Inhale, back to center and complete onto the second side. Inhale, back to center. Inhale, exhale a couple of times. The next inhalation, turn the head up. Look up into the ceiling, fully exhale, chin at the chest, look down, inhale, up, should be able to feel some stretches at the throat, exhale, look down, then in circular fashion, turn the head towards right, going upward, and we inhale. From the up, exhale towards left, chin at the chest, two more circles, inhale on right, exhale on left. Then reverse the direction, the total 3 circles, inhale on left, exhale on right. And let's warm up the waist and below. Sit into L shape, Dandasana, ball pose, with help of both the palms. Keep the back straight. We can lean slightly forward, pull the toes slightly in. Roll or squeeze the toes in and out. As we inhale, push all the toes together forward. Exhale, pull them back. Inhale forward, exhale back. Few times, alternate. Then circle the toes around the heels. Try to keep the knees straight. Legs will remain fully grounded so we can have better stretches at the calf muscles, lower legs. And reverse the direction. And relax. Fall at the knee, right knee. And interlock the right toes with left fingers. Keep on pushing the right knee down to the floor. Two times. Now bring the knee to the chin. Inhale, press it down to the floor. A couple of seconds while we hold the breath in. Exhale, bring the knee to the chin. Couple more times. On the same side. Relax and straighten the right leg and fold at the left knee. Same thing onto the left side. Try to keep the back straight, trunk vertical. So the other leg straight, toes pointed out. Bring the left knee to the chin. Inhale, press it down. Exhale. And into the chin, inhale down. Couple more times, onto the same side. And then fold at both the knees. Align both the feet together. Interlock the fingers, place them over the toes. Thumbs will go under the big toes. Knees all the way up. Push them all the way down. One more time, all the way up, all the way down. Then speed up the flapping up and down. Keep the mind into all these activities. Can feel any kind of sensations, compressions, extensions into the body parts, joints, muscles, whichever parts we are utilizing in the activity. Okay, now stop the flapping and roll the body side by side, holding the heels together at the same place, and we are moving our upper body towards the heels. So heels closer to the perineum, then grab the toes tightly and push the knees down to the floor. Try to keep the back straight. This is Baddhasana or Bhadrasana. Close the eyes, deep inhale, hold the breath in lower abdomen and feel the stretches into the pelvis area and hip joints. Exhale, deep inhale again. Hold the breath for 7 seconds and make sure our knees are pressed down, back straight during that time. And feel the stretches, keep awareness. Exhale. Let's do a couple more times. move it own pace. Slowly open the eyes once when you're done. Then holding the heels closer to the perineum, deep breath in, and we will try to do Baddha Konasana. Deep exhale as we bend forward as far as we can go, because we feel so much extension, so much stretches into the thigh muscles, hip joints. Inhale, back up. Let's do one more time. Deep exhale, bend down. Breathe in and out, normal. Try to keep pushing the head and trunk further down and down with each exhalation. Inhale, come back up. And let's sit into cross-legged posture. And sit Siddhasana, Sukhasana, half lotus or full lotus. If you're able to sit into lotus pose, that would be great. Keep both hands sideways. To Parvatasana with full awareness as we inhale, bring both the hands together in front of the chest as a pranam. Exhale here, inhale again, raise both hands up, rest them onto the top of the head. Exhale, deep inhale as we straighten our elbows and raise both the palms all the way up. The palms are completely aligned, elbows straight, biceps at the ears. As we start lowering our hand, we should do a one long exhalation while we bring the palms on top of the head, at the chest, and all the way down. Let's do two more times. Do with our own pace. Do with breath coordination, with full awareness. Close the eyes so we can have better awareness. Once completed, then bring both the hands into Dhyan Mudra. Connect the first fingertip and thumb tip together. Relax, rest both the hands onto the thighs or knees. Do Bhastrika Pranayama. Keep the back straight. Relax shoulders. Align the head, neck, and trunk in one line. And that line should be vertical. Make sure we are sitting vertical. Deeply, slowly inhale and deeply, slowly exhale. We are trying to fill up the lungs completely, fully, and we are emptying them fully. feel that we are fully filling them up and emptying them. Whenever we are filling up the lungs, make sure at end, then we cannot breathe in further. It has to be stop point. That way we notice that we are breathing fully. Same way we are when emptying the lungs, at the end, make sure there are nothing left. Even we try to exhale further, there is nothing. So we should reach up to that point. Slowly open the eyes and breathe in and out normal. Next, let's do Surya Bhedan Pranayam with Kumbhaka. So first, let's make a Vishnu Mudra on right hand, roll first two fingers into root of thumb. We will do Puraka, that means inhale on right. We can block both the nostrils, we will hold the breath. That means Kumbhaka. This is Antar Kumbhaka. When we hold the breath in, Antar Kumbhaka, then we will exhale or Rechaka. Rechak from left means exhale from left. So one way only. So we will block the left nostril again, open up the right nostril, inhale on right, hold the breath in. And exhale on left. Each time inhale on right, each time exhale on left. If you want to count, you can do 6 count inhale, 7 count hold, 8 count exhale. Exhale usually always longer than inhale. When you breathe out on left and breathe in and out normal. After that, we will do Kapalbhati Pranayam with two mudras together. We will do Apan Vayu Mudra. First, we'll do Vayu Mudra, roll first fingertip into root of thumb. Then next two fingertips connect with thumb. Only the little finger will remain straight. Apan Mudra and Vayu Mudra together, Apan Vayu. Now deeply inhale, fill up the lungs fully, and then exhale, forcefully exhale, exhale, exhale till end. Then fill up again, and then forceful exhalation in multiple exhalations, we are emptying the lungs. Frequency of the stroke you can keep as per your comfort level. Now conclude when you completely breathe out, then breathe in and out normal. Bring the body into Sambhavya Mudra for 10 seconds. For that, open up the palms towards ceiling, tilt the head slightly up, close the eyes, keep awareness in between the eyebrows, completely still the body for 10 more seconds. Feel the vibrations, let them come down. Let the energy get absorbed into the body. And come back. Next, we'll do variation of Bhastrika Pranayama. Make loose fist at the shoulders, folded elbow at the ribs. Deep inhale and deep exhale, just normal one round. Then forceful inhale. We extend both hands up, open up the palms, exhale, bring them down, make a fist, inhale up, exhale down. If you have heart problem, blood pressure issue, do it slowly. Relax, breathe in and out normal. Bring the body into Sambhavya Mudra for 10 seconds. And let's do second time, slight different. Deep inhale, deep exhale, one round, normal. And start, inhale up, exhale down, inhale front, inhale back, inhale sideways, chill back. And relax. Sambhavya Mudra for 10 seconds. Slowly come back, open up the eyes. Let's do a Linga Mudra. Bring the right hand forward. Keep the right thumb pointing towards ceiling. Interlock the left hand finger such a way that the right thumb will be surrounded by left thumb and left first finger. You can hold the mudra at the shoulder level. If you like, you can hold at the elbows if it comforts you. back straight. You can close the eyes. Keep the awareness at the solar plexus, the Manipura Chakra, the Nabhi Kendra. Inhale, exhale, normal. Full awareness at Nabhi Chakra. And relax. Hands. And let's straighten the legs. Obhishta Konasana. Legs are fully grounded. Inhale. Both hands up. Look up. You can lean slightly backward to accommodate more air. As we exhale, bend forward and down. Try to bend from the lower back. Grab the feet right to right, left to left. Keep pushing the head and trunk further down. Inhale, come back up. Second round. Fully exhale, bend down. We can inhale, exhale normal. So we can stay longer in pose. Each exhalation, we will keep pushing head and trunk further down and down. Inhale, come back up. Turn the upper body towards the right side. Fully exhale, bend down. Grab the right foot equally with both the hands. And try to bring the forehead onto the right knee. Inhale, come back up. Towards left. Inhale, come back up and fold at the left knee. Bring the left heel at the perineum. Turn the shoulder blade perpendicular to the right leg. Inhale, raise both hands up, look up. Fully exhale, bend down for the Dhanu Sirsasana. Forehead at the right knee. Breathe in and out normal. So each exhalation, we will keep pushing our head and trunk further down and down. 10, 9, 8, 2, 1. Inhale, come back up. And Parivritta Dhanu Sirsasana, bring the right hand at the right big toe. Grab the big toe. Inhale, left hand up. As we exhale, bring the left hand also onto the right big toe. Keep looking up into the ceiling or at least corner of the ceiling. Relax lower back. Inhale, come back up and switch to the other side. Dhanu Sirsasana towards left. Shoulder blade perpendicular to the left leg. Inhale, both hands up, look up. Fully exhale, bend down. Grab the left foot equally with both the hands. Forehead onto the left knee. Inhale, exhale, normal. Each exhalation, keep pushing head and trunk further down. 10, 9, 8, 2, 1. Inhale, come back up. And Parivritta Dhanu Sirsasana. Do with breath coordination, with full awareness. Both the hands onto the left big toe. Keep looking up. Relax the lower back. Inhale, come back up. And bring both the legs in the front, straighten them. You can separate a couple of feet apart, relax the upper body with help of the palms. You can roll the toes in and out. By keeping the knees straight, legs grounded, we can feel the movements all the way at the hip joints. Breathe in and out normal with closed eyes. Feel the body, feel the movements. Come back and relax. And align the feet together. Inhale. Raise both hands up. You can lean slightly backward to accommodate more air. Fully exhale, bend forward. Tuck the stomach inward. That means apply the Uddiyana Bandha, grab the feet. Push head and trunk further down onto the knees and hold it down. And look at you can hold the breath out. Paschimottanasana. Inhale, come back up. Second time. Inhale, come back up. And complementary pose, Purva Uttanasana, with help of the palms. Next inhalation, raise the lower back up, push the toes into the floor, and look into the back wall. Body will assume one straight line from back of the head to the heels. So heels on the floor, toes on the floor, lower back as high as possible. Elbows straight, knees straight for most of the people. During offline, wherever you do this pose, try to measure the time and you may be able to stay for half minute or 2 minutes. You can gradually increase the duration. Very slowly bring the body down. So those all of these activities will strengthen our muscles, joints, our various body parts. Let's do Vakrasana. Next, hold at the right knee. Bring the right foot closer to the left knee. And right hand at the back. Try to bring it as close as possible. Align palm with the spine at the back. Inhale, raise the left hand up. And bring the left hand outward of the right knee. Fully exhale and twist towards the right. Align chin with the right shoulder. If we have extra flexibility, we can push our right knee towards left and grab the left knee. Inhale and we come back. Straighten and relax. The right leg, and we will do Vakrasana toward left side. Do with breath coordination, with full awareness, with bandha means when we twist, we should hold breath out and hold the stomach inward. So we are utilizing all the four aspects of the yoga. I would say the better yoga. Inhale, come back. And let's sit into Vajrasana. For 2 seconds, it's been 40 minutes. Let's take a break, let's relax. Let the body weight automatically settle down, maybe equally distributed, the left and right. So let's relax, try not to hold the pose, let it be completely on the gravity. Open up the palms towards ceiling. You can close the eyes. Breathe in and out normal. Feel the body internally. Each inhalation energizes the body, increase our prana level. Each exhalation relaxes body, throws out the toxin. Slowly open the eyes and let's do Mandukasana, frog pose. Keep the knees slightly out, not completely closed, just like a 2-3 fingers. We should be able to put it in. Extend both hands in the front, make tight fist, keep the thumbs inside. Deep inhale, hold the breath in lower abdomen, then place the fist in between the ribcage and navel. Forcefully exhale, and without leaving the heels, push the head and trunk all the way down. When we can no longer push the trunk down, hold it there and tilt the head slightly up. Inhale, come back up. Second time. Frog pose, Mandukasana, exact same way, same sequence, tight fist. Deep inhale, hold the breath and place top of the fist in proper place. Fully exhale, forceful. Bend down and tilt the head up. Inhale, come back up. And next we'll do complementary pose. We'll do backward bending, supine vajrasana or supta vajrasana. If you like, you can do while sitting in virasana and then you can go backward bending if that is easier for you. To do this pose from vajrasana requires a little bit more flexibility. Help of the palms and elbows. Let the whole upper body completely rest onto the floor and back of the hand on the floor. Raise both hands up and rest the palms onto the thighs. Close the eyes. Relax lower back, hip joints, thigh muscles, knee joints, calf muscles. And keep awareness on those body parts which we just relaxed. You notice that there are multiple body parts that are feeling either extension or compression. So whenever you need to come out of the pose, grab both ankles, push the elbows into the floor, and bring the body up back into a comfortable sitting posture. Next, let's separate the knees a couple of feet apart. Bring both the hands in between the knees. Deep inhale. As we deep exhale, let's walk the hands forward one at a time. And let the trunk and head completely go down. So chest and chin will be rested onto the floor. Our hands are fully extended front. Our heels are still connected with the hips. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Relax shoulders, relax hip joints, relax lower back. Inhale, head inhalation, tilt the head up and start walking hands towards the body. Let head and trunk rise. Back to Vajrasana pose. Next, let's go on to the knees. We will do Urdhva Ustrasana, half camel pose. Separate the knee joints and the feet same at the shoulder width. Both hands at the waist, fingertips pointing down. Next inhalation, arch backward, look into the back wall. Push the pelvis forward and bring elbows closer to each other. And please apply some force. In 2 seconds, if you are able to transition into the full camel pose, then you can try one hand at a time. So you can bring one hand onto the corresponding heel, and then you can move the next hand onto the another heel. Bend down a little further, keep looking into the back wall, keep pushing the pelvis further forward, stay in the pose, full camel pose, if you're able to transition, and slowly come out of the pose, in circular fashion, bring the hand one at a time, and finally, straighten the trunk. Now let's bend forward, bring both palms onto the floor, knees on the floor, toes on the floor. Deep inhale, as we deep exhale, bring the left palm under the body, bring it toward the right side, and left side of the face on the floor, make a fist on the right hand, and bring the right hand at the back. Now twist the upper body towards right and look into the ceiling. We can push the back of the left palm into the floor for the better twisting. You can inhale, exhale normal. Next inhalation, we can bring the right palm back onto the floor, left palm onto the floor, and back to double dog pose. Inhale, exhale a couple of times. Next, deep inhale, as we exhale, bring the right hand under the body towards left and the right side of the face onto the floor, make a fist onto the left hand, bring the left hand at back of the body and twist the upper body towards left side and look into the ceiling. Push the back of the right hand or the right palm into the floor for the better twisting. Inhale, exhale, normal. Next inhalation, bring the left palm onto the floor, right palm onto the floor, and body back into the tabletop pose. Inhale, exhale, normal. Let's do Vyakrasana, the tiger pose. Look up into the front wall. Kick the right foot back, right knee straight, the right leg is parallel to the floor, right toes stretch towards back wall. Relax the lower back, inhale, exhale, normal. Next inhalation, hold the right leg without dropping the knee. You can turn around and make sure the knee is folded at 90 degrees. Our right toes pointed toward the ceiling. Make any adjustment if you need to. Then again, look into the front wall as high as possible. Continue relaxing the lower back. Breathe in and out normal. Next inhalation, raise the left hand up and grab the right foot and pull the right leg up as high as possible while keep looking up into the front wall. Next exhalation, bring the left hand and right knee back onto the floor. Inhale, exhale, normal, back into the tabletop pose. Keep looking into the front wall. And let's do tiger pose onto the left side. Next inhalation, kick the left foot towards back wall, left knee straight, left leg parallel to the floor, left toes pointed towards back wall. Breathe in and out normal, relax the lower back. Keep looking up as high as possible into the front wall. Next inhalation, fold the left knee at 90 degree. Look around and make any adjustment if you need to. Keep looking into the front wall. Inhale, exhale, normal. Keep relaxing the lower back. Next inhalation, raise the right hand up and grab the left foot. Keep pulling the left foot up while keep looking up into the front wall. Inhale, exhale, normal. Very slowly with next exhalation, bring the right palm and left knee back onto the floor. Back to tabletop pose. Inhale, exhale, normal. And get back onto the knees. Half stand. And then stand up. Relax the hands, feet, thighs, legs. Do Tadasana. Next inhalation. Interlock the fingers, palms upside down. Go on the toes. Stretch the palms toward the ceiling. The whole body is stretched upward. Exhale, down. Heels also back onto the floor. One more time. Inhale, go up. Down. And next we will do Utkatasana, chair pose. You can separate the feet a few inches apart. As we inhale, go on the toes, raise both hands up halfway. As we exhale, bend down. Keep staying on the toes. Pretend that we are sitting into an imaginary chair. But unfortunately, the chair is too low. Inhale, come back up. And let's walk onto the heels. Make the two rounds around the mat. And then we will walk two rounds on the toes. Try to keep the smaller steps, so we can keep our knees as straight as possible. Still activate the lymphatic system throughout the body fairly quickly. Separate the feet 3 to 4 feet apart. Interlock the fingers, stretch the hands up, palms upside down, stretch the body upward, deep inhale. As we exhale, bend towards one side while keep looking up. Tiryak Tadasana, swaying palm tree pose. Inhale, back to center, stretch the body upward, exhale onto the second side. Inhale, come back to center. So whichever side, let's do one more time. Whichever side you're bending, first try to toes pointed out on that side and do one more time. So that will have a better stability and we should be able to go even further down. Inhale, come back and switch the feet position. And onto the other side. Inhale, come back up and separate the feet at the farthest. Knees straight, extend both hands in the front. We will do Kati Chakrasana, deep inhale. As we exhale, twist the upper body towards one side, keep following the one palm all the way back. Other palm will go onto the opposite side shoulder. 5, 6, 7. Inhale, back to center. Exhale to the second side. We are just twisting the waist and above. Our hips, legs should be completely still. Elbows and palms stay at the shoulder level all the time. Inhale, come back. One more time, both the sides. Kati Chakrasana, waist rotation. You can feel some great stretches at the lower back and around the waist muscles. Inhale, come back. And complete onto the second side. Inhale, come back. Relax both hands. Now turn the right foot towards the right side. Hold at the right knee. Extend both hands sideways. As we inhale, raise the left hand up. As we exhale, bring the left palm beside the right foot and raise the right hand up into the ceiling. Look up into the ceiling through the palm. So twisted Parsva Konasana, Parivrutta Parsva Konasana. Inhale, come back up and to the second side. So left knee bend close to 90 degree. Inhale, raise the right hand up. As we exhale, bring the right palm beside the left foot. Raise the left hand up toward the ceiling and look up into the ceiling. Parivrutta Parsva Konasana. Parivrutta means twisted. Inhale, back to center. And bring feet together. So let's do Super Brain Yoga. So we can grab the earlobes on opposite side. And we will try to do up to 10. If you can do, you cannot do 10, that's okay. So do as many as possible. Yep, most people made it. Relax a little bit and we will do balancing pose. Mm-hmm. Vrikshasan, tree pose. Very slowly get into the pose. You turn on one side, then get transition into the second side. So, how many people have a yoga block? Handy. Do any? Okay. Looks like most people doesn't have. So, if you have a yoga block, then try to do Ardha Chandrasana. Right. The reason we need block is because the length of our feet is more than length of our arm. So if we are going into the Ardha Chandrasana, just try to cover up some height. And you can do without yoga block as well. So I think I recommend you, all of you should have yoga block and some strap, all different kind of strap. Like this is the elastic one. It has the holding also like this. So sometime if you certain kind of activities, so you can just pass the hand into like certain distance, and you can just keep them, like whatever exercise you do, you can hold them together. So there are all different kind of things, and you can buy in, comes in a whole set as well. So if you haven't done, I was just showing that, I'm not going to use it now, I'm just showing that we should all have yoga block and those strap and those kind of certain props. Let's complete the Ardha Chandrasana onto the second side. If you have not yet, you can raise the leg as high as possible. Maybe you can try, if you have a very good balance, you can try without block, but it will be a little challenging. So the hand has to go all the way down. Okay. That's good, good try, good balance. Cool. So let's relax, lay down onto the stomach. 2 seconds. Relax in crocodile pose, Makarasana. Breathe in and out normal. Let all the body parts, muscles be on their own, on the gravity. Don't try to hold.
Okay, let's do Dhanurasana, bow pose. Fall at both the knees. Grab the ankles. Next inhalation, pull both legs up. Upper body will automatically get lifted up. Pull the legs as high as possible. Make sure the thighs is not touching the floor. There will be some rocking movements as we breathe in and out. That will be beneficial as it massages the organs into the lower abdomen area. Very slowly bring the body down and lay down into Makarasana, crocodile pose for 10 seconds. Come back, and next we will do Sampurna Bhujangasana. Bring both legs together, palms on top of each other under the chest. Folded elbow will go on a sideway, forehead onto the floor. You can straight the toes out. Next inhalation, just raise the upper body up, straighten both elbows, look up into the ceiling, feel some compression at the lumbar area, extension at the stomach area. Exhale, lower the upper body back to the floor. Inhale, exhale a couple of times, and we will do one more time. Deep inhale as we go up. Sampurna Bhujangasana, full cobra pose. In Surya Namaskars, we do usually like halfway. Exhale, bring the body down and lay down into Makarasana, crocodile pose for 10 seconds. And let's turn around, lay down on a back. And we will do Pavan Muktasana with both legs together, fold at both the knees, grab both the legs in both the arms, deep inhale. As we deep exhale, lift the head up. Try to bring the knees to the face and face to the knees. Hold them together as long as we hold the breath out. Inhale, bring the head back onto the floor. Continue holding the lower legs tightly. We can roll our body side by side. Stay within the mat area that massages the back. We can go all the way from one folded elbow to the other side folded elbow onto the floor. That could be almost half done. So that was roll. Now let's rock forward and backward. Bring feet onto the floor to the back of the head on the floor. Massage the spine. Straighten and relax legs. Lay down in Shavasana for 10 seconds. Full relax, open up the palm towards ceiling, fingers semi-closed, hands at comfortable place away from the body, both feet at least a couple of feet apart, toes pointed out.
most importantly, let all the body parts, joints, muscle be on their own on the gravity. Breathe in and out normal, head, neck, trunk will be in one straight line for the energy flow smoothly. Next, we'll do the breathe pose. Hold at both the knees, bring the heels at the hips, grab the ankles. This is inversion pose. So if you're unable to do inversion, then you can just jump directly into the Matsyasana, the fish pose. And we all will join that. So with breathe pose, just push the lower back up. We can bring our hands at the lower back to lift it up even a little higher. Stay in breath pose for 2 more seconds. Of course, you can do some variation over here if you want to raise the one leg up. Ek paad setu bandhasana. So you can do one leg at a time. If you have ability, you can lift up both the legs together too. So Dvipad Setu Bandhasana. And very slowly come back, bring the body down into the floor, lay down in Shavasana for 10 seconds. After that, transition into the Matsyasana.
Stay in Matsyasana for about 20 seconds. Meantime, I will set up the Yog Nidra audio. Stay in Matsyasana. If you like, you can prepare yourself for Yog Nidra. You can turn the lights down. You can cover yourself up. Whichever way comforts you. Okay, lay down in Shavasana. For next 9 minutes, we will be following the audio instructions. Try to follow completely. Breathe in and out normal, close the eyes. And let's start.
शरीर को पूरी तरह से फ्लोर पर सरेंडर कर दिया है। शरीर का पूरा वजन फ्लोर पर ट्रांसफर हो रहा है। और अभी मैं जो जो बॉडी पार्ट्स का नाम बोलूं वहां अपनी अवेयरनेस लाना है और वो बॉडी पार्ट को रिलैक्स करते जाएंगे। रिलैक्स ऑल योर टूज वन बाय वन। रिलैक्स बोथ योर फीट, सोल, हील्स। Relax your calf muscles, your lower legs, knee joint. Now bring your awareness on your thighs, relax your thighs. So now both your legs are completely relaxed. Now bring your awareness on your lower abdomen. नाभि से नीचे के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे. और ध्यान लाएंगे नाभि के ऊपर, अपने बेली बटन पर ध्यान लाएंगे. अभी अवेयरनेस लाएंगे पेट पर, पेट के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे. पेट के सभी ऑर्गन्स पर रिलैक्स कर देंगे. अवेयरनेस थोड़ी ऊपर की तरफ शिफ्ट करेंगे और चेस्ट के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे. चेस्ट के सभी ऑर्गन्स भी रिलैक्स कर देंगे, लंग्स, हार्ट. दोनों हाथ रिलैक्स कर देंगे, दोनों हाथ की सभी फिंगर्स, दोनों पाम्स, हथेली, दोनों रिस्ट, दोनों लोअर आर्म्स, एल्बोस, अपर आर्म्स, दोनों शोल्डर्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे. और अभी चेस्ट के सेंटर में ध्यान लाएंगे. फील द वाइब्रेशंस इन योर बॉडी. और अभी ध्यान लाएंगे गले के ऊपर और गले के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे. फिर फेस पर ध्यान लाएंगे और फेस के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स करते जाएंगे. चिन रिलैक्स करेंगे, लिप्स, दोनों चीक्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे, नोज, दोनों ईयर्स, दोनों आईज, आईब्रोज, फोरहेड एंड टॉप ऑफ द हेड. फील द वाइब्रेशंस इन योर बॉडी. Your whole body is relaxed now. Now we will chant three Om, और Om के vibrations पूरे शरीर में महसूस करेंगे. नाभि से start करते हुए Om बोलेंगे और वाइब्रेशंस पूरे शरीर में फील करेंगे. स्टार्ट, ब्रीथ इन Oh. breathe in. Feel the vibrations in your body. ओम की वाइब्रेशंस शरीर के अंदर भी है और शरीर के बाहर भी है. मूवमेंट करके ये वाइब्रेशन को डिस्टर्ब नहीं करेंगे. खाली आनंद की अनुभूति करेंगे, परम शांति का अनुभव करेंगे. अपने आप को एकदम हैप्पी हैप्पी महसूस करेंगे. अपने आप को एकदम हेल्दी महसूस करेंगे. ग्रेटिट्यूड की फीलिंग कि भगवान ने मुझे सब कुछ दिया है. अभी जो फीलिंग्स है उसे बनाए रखेंगे. धीरे से बॉडी के प्रति सजग हो जाएंगे. हेड को साइड टू साइड मूव करेंगे. शरीर को एक स्ट्रेच दे देंगे. दोनों हाथ ऊपर की तरफ खींच लेंगे.
Rub the palms against each other. Chandra Kurja Mijjam Vam. Let's warm hands over the eyes in peace. Open and close eyes a few times in dark. Slowly slide the hands down. Gently open the eyes. Extend both hands sideways, palms facing down. Bring both legs closer. Hold at the knees. Heels at the hips. Deep inhale. As we deep exhale, drop both the knees together onto the floor, onto left side. Turn the head towards right. Push the palms into the floor and feel the twist at the middle of the spine. Inhale, back up. Exhale to the other side. Both knees onto the floor towards right, head towards left. Push the palms into the floor and feel the stretches. Inhale, back to center again. Let's do one more time. Knees towards left, head towards right. Inhale, back to center. Finally, drop both the knees towards right, head towards left for a few seconds. And bring the whole body towards right. Stay on right for two more breaths in and out. And very slowly bring the body up back into any comfortable sitting posture. Could be Vajrasana, Virasana, Sukhasana, Siddhasana, half lotus, full lotus, Swastikasana, anything. Your choice. And let's bring the right hand into Vishnu Mudra. And we will do Chandra Bhedan Pranayam with Kumbhaka. So deep inhale on left. Hold the breath and exhale on right. Again, block the right nostril, open up the left, breathe in on left. So one way only, If you like, you can add the counting. 6, breathe in. 7, hold. 8, breathe out. Complete the last round, then we breathe out on right, then just complete. Relax both hands. Next, we will do 3 Bhramari Pranayam, followed by 10 seconds of Sambhavi Mudra. And next we'll do Anulom Vilom Pranayam. Make Vishnu Mudra on right hand, deep inhale on left, deep exhale on right, deep inhale on right, deep exhale on left. Keep on doing left to right to left, full round. Conclude the round when we breathe out on left. Then let's complete the session. Bring both palms on top of each other into the left. Close eyes, relax shoulders, back straight. We will chant Mahamrityunjaya Mantra 3 times, everybody together, followed by short meditation. During meditation, try to keep the awareness at the crown of the head, the Sahasrara Chakra. That we will end by 1 Omkar chant and closing prayer. So let's start with Mahamrityunjaya Mantra. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanat Mrityor Mukshiyamamrita Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanat Mrityor
यजामहे सुगंधिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् पूर्वार्गमेव बन्धनात् मृत्योर्मुक्षीयमामृता
ॐ सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
Rub the palms against each other, generate urja, make them warm. Press warm hand over the eyes and face, move the palms over the eyes, fingers cross over the forehead, gently massage the eyelids. Blink the eyes few times under the palms in dark. Slowly slide the hands down over the face, gently open the eyes. Rub the palms one more time. Place them on top of the head, back of the head, neck, shoulders, arms, trunk, legs, back, throughout the body to spread the energy within. Hari Om Tat Sat Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good evening, everybody. That concludes our Wednesday session. Hari Om Tat Sat Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Jai Sri Krishna, Jai Swami Narayan. Good evening, Anne. Good night. I'm going to let you guys unmute. We are here for 2 more seconds.
Thank you, Bukul Bhai.
I didn't know all
this.
Thank you, Bukul Bhai. Jai Sri Krishna, Jai Swaminarayan.
Jai Swaminarayan. All right. See you tomorrow morning.
All right.